There's a new study out of South Africa indicating that this new COVID variant, Omicron, it partly evades the Pfizer vaccine. But a researcher behind the study says that the findings could have been much worse. Alex Siegel of Africa Health Research Institute telling CNN, quote, I thought this news was very positive. I expected worse. This is not a variant that has completely escaped. It certainly escapes. It is certainly bad. But it looks to me like there are ways of dealing with it. And joining us now is Dr. Angelique Coetzee. She is the national chair of South Africa's Medical Association. She's one of the first doctors to be treating patients who are sickened with the Omicron variant. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us this morning or this afternoon in your case. First, can you just give us an update on the patients that you're seeing? Are you still seeing mild symptoms or has that advanced?
Thank you and good evening to you all. Well, South Africa, it's good afternoon. Thank you for asking. Yes, let me just give you a brief overview of this past few days of the patients that I've seen. I have made some stats of my 64 patients that I've seen recently. 37 not vaccinated, 2 with reinfections. And then, yes, the question that you ask, Pfizer, 19 reinfections with Pfizer. The 2 reinfections that I'm talking about is patients that had been COVID before and then got it again. So it's got nothing to do with vaccines. And then on Johnson & Johnson, I saw 7 breakthrough infections. Then interesting, I have 2 patients reinfected, had COVID before, then been vaccinated, fully vaccinated. And in the beginning, we saw more males, but now the ratio is exactly the same, 32 males, 32 females. So children, remember, in our country, we do not vaccinate children under the age of 12, but I have seen 11 children under the age of 13, and that is from 4 months old. And above 50 years, I've seen 15 patients. So to come back to that question regarding the vaccines, yes, I think there's a slight escape of the vaccines regarding Omicron. But interesting enough, it's mild disease. And that is what was always been said. If, we promote our vaccines in our country to say the vaccines are supposed to protect you against severe disease. It's supposed to protect you at least between 94-96% and hospitalization. If I look at the facts in the public sector hospital, the majority, and I know it's 90 plus, of people in the ICUs are unvaccinated people. Very, very few people at this stage admitted that with previous being vaccinated. And also, we know that there's a hype out there that children are getting more infected at this stage, which is not really, if you look at the data, we are seeing a lot of upper respiratory tract infections, RSV, viral infections. We didn't really saw them during our winter time. Mm-hmm. And those children will then be admitted for that. And then coincidentally, they would test positive for COVID, but it's a huge scare out there. But if you look at the facts, it's not predominantly for COVID-19.
That's an important distinction. Can you tell us a little bit more about the reinfections? Because you mentioned people who have had COVID before and are unvaccinated and get reinfected. I know there aren't many that you've seen. You also mentioned people who have had COVID, gotten vaccinated, and now, I believe this is what you're saying, still reinfected with this Omicron variant. Can you tell us how long between infection and reinfection and the timeline between infection, vaccination, and reinfection in those cases?
Good question. So according to my data, the average timeline is last Pfizer dosage around between any time between end of July till end of August. But I saw one patient who had been vaccinated October and got a breakthrough infection. So it seems as if 3 months, more or less, then after you have been vaccinated, you can be infected again. And that's more or less, look at, if you look at some of the data that Pfizer released, there is a definite decline in the protection. But again, I need to stress, for now, it still protects against severe disease.
Yeah.
As the disease patterns that we are seeing are mild on these people that's been vaccinated.
It's a very good point. This is not an argument, certainly, as we look at these numbers against vaccination. This is proving why people should get vaccinated indeed. Dr. Coetzee, thank you for being with us.
Thank you so much. And please get vaccinated and get your boosters.
Oh, I am boosted. We are so boosted on this set, doctor. Thank you so much.